cells form the basic units of life. We know this. And by now, we even know how the discovery of cells, as seen in the tree cork, was a breakthrough in biological studies. Now it's time to have a look at how the cells actually look under a microscope. For this, we select onion peel as our specimen. But before we begin with the procedure, let's first collect the necessary requirements. We will need a microscope, a slide, a cover slip, iodine solution, water, and forceps. Anything else we're left with? Well, the most important of all is the specimen, that is an onion peel. Now that we're all set with the equipment needed, let's begin with the amazing experiment of observing the onion cells under the microscope. Firstly, we take the onion peel and with the help of the forceps, pull away the thin lining from the inner surface. Before placing this on the slide, we first add a drop of water on, then place the onion peel on it. We are not supposed to touch the peel and even the slide with our fingers. Next, we add 2 drops of dilute iodine solution. Hold on, do you know why is iodine solution added to this specimen? We do this so that we can clearly see all the parts of the cell. Else it's difficult to study them as they are transparent. It would even be difficult to differentiate between the various parts. Now we place a cover slip in this manner and make sure that no air bubbles are formed on the slide. With this, our slide is ready. This entire process of setting up the microscope along with the slide is termed mounting. It's also important to see that there is enough light falling on the mirror of the microscope. Shall we observe it now? Here we go. Wow, doesn't it look amazing? Now, before studying these, tell me one thing. Do plants and animal cells look the same? Do they have the same organelles? Or are the two types different in some ways? Well, plant and animal cells are slightly different. When cells from a human cheek are scraped with a sterile cotton bud and mounted, similar but not exactly same cells are seen under the microscope. Roughly, we have these thick, distinct borders that differentiate each cell from the other one. Then we have these thin, tiny dark spots scattered all over. Also, we can spot this prominent circular structure here, which is very darkly stained. Any ideas what these things are? Well, these are the cell constituents. Let's get introduced to each in the next video.